Alright guys, and we're back to the second battle between my friend Danny and I for the Colosseum tournament. And here, like I said previously, the rules were that you pick 6 Pokemon, you can't change items, anything. You just change the order of what of who goes first. So this time around, he's gonna go into the... It's a doable choice. He had me worried for a minute because he has Mamoswine, and that's Earthquake, Stealth Rocks, Icicle Crash, Ice Shard. I don't know, he would bring him up first, and I got Retiari, which is my Tyranitar. Here, I would most definitely, in most cases, I would just go Stealth Rock, take the Earthquake, and then Focus Sash. But in here, yeah, he does go for the Stealth Rock. But what I didn't want to happen is that I'd be 1 HP, and then I have no way to come back into the game with Tyranitar, and he would die, and then I'll be stuck in a sun the whole entire game, which would, it wouldn't be that bad because I have Charizard in Tentacruel, but it would hurt me quite a bit, so I would rather not run that, I would rather not risk that. So I did bring out Chestnut over here, and with Chestnut, he kind of tanks Mamoswine because of the Earthquake, and he survives the Ice Shard because of how bulky he is. The Icicle Crash does wreck it. But in the meantime, while that happens, I did put on some damage. I went for the Hammer Arm. I brought it down quite a bit. I went for the Spikes as well. All that good stuff. And because he has Rocking Helmet, it hurts me a lot. But I also have Leftovers, so it mitigates some of the damage, or it compensates for it. So that's fine. The Chestnut is as good as that, I'd say. But at least I got Mamoswine out of the way, which is what I wanted the most, because I don't want to risk any other Pokemon to die in here. Chestnut fainted, but he did his job, so that's completely fine. Now I'm still alive, but I'm bringing out a Pokemon that's not very hurt by Stealth Rocks, and that's Greninja. And with Greninja, obviously I'm gonna go into the Grass Knot, but he switched out. When he switched out, he went into Trevenant. With Trevenant, it didn't do so much damage, but it did a little, because it's Staff, Grass Knot, all that stuff, you know, and he's also Ghost. But after season ahead of Grass Knot, does absolutely nothing. I'm getting ahead of myself over here. So the Sandstorm cleared out. I get out into Mermillo, my Tentacruel. Because, one, I am so fucking stupid that I completely forgot that it's Ghost type. So I did go for the big no-no here. I went into Rapid Spin. Spoiler. Yeah, so he made Horn Leech, does quite a bit of damage, but I still live because I'm so resistant to it. He goes for the Protect, and I go for Rapid Spin, like a nub. But it kind of didn't matter because he's protected, so in a way, it just never happened the way I see it. It just never happened, so that's whatever. He goes up for Ninetales, and I have Protected to go into Toxic Trevenant, but Ninetales get it. So Ninetales gets wrecked. So now his first option of route has been Toxic, so it's gonna get worn down bit by bit over here. Also, he hit by Spikes, so might have broken any stash that he might have, or I really don't know what Ninetales plays, so maybe a Heat Rock, I don't know. Now could have most definitely gone for the Scout, but the Scout, you know, it's not gonna do anything. I probably did go for the Scout. I went for Rapid Spin actually. Rapid Spin, I needed to do that because I didn't want to risk having that in the game the whole entire time when I had Charizard without me Mega Evolved yet. And if I didn't do that, I would probably get wrecked because it'd be a half HP. I mean, I could probably find an opportune time to go in and Mega and Roost and be completely good, but I'd rather not run that risk. So I go into Victor Bell. Of course, he's poisoned. I don't want to get poisoned, but he goes for that Solar Beam and does some damage, I guess, whatever. Here, it didn't really matter if I went Mega or not, because I'm fire and I'm in the sun. I cannot be Will-O-Wisp by the Trevenant over here, which I'm sure he has it, I guess, because I saw he got Horn Leech Protect. I don't know. So I kept on as it is because of the... I know when I get hit by something that I might weak to. So I kept on, I Dragon Dance, I went for a Flurry Blitz. I didn't want to Outrage like Game 1, because in Game 1, I kind of paid the price for doing that, because I got confused, and I got hit by Confusion twice. So now we do a little mega showdown between Charizard X. That's what happens. So I said out loud, yo, mega showdown, let's go. So I went into Mega Charizard X, and she went into Mega Charizard Y. But I'm already plus one, Dragon Dance. If that had not happened, it would be at a speed tie. It would have been a 50-50 on who goes first, which one would have been quite epic. But anyways, I wasn't Dragon Dance, so I was gonna win that race. And I went for the outrage because I didn't want a third blitz. And the outrage pretty much does what I needed to do. Brings down the his Mega Pokemon, and I'm stuck on the outrage. So I'm gonna hit the Nemo's one over here. He does Ice Shard me, and I think that's gonna be a fate on my part because I'm gonna hit him, and then I'm gonna get hit by the Rocky Helmet. So even though Charizard didn't last very long, he did take down the Mega and the Mamoswine, which has a prior move, the Ice Shard, so that's pretty good. And then I don't quite remember what I bring out next, but yeah, okay, Tyranitar. Tyranitar will clear out the Sun, that's fine, that works out well. Now, he does have this guy right here, the Arcanine, and I really don't know what he had, I forgot. I think he had like the electric move, the extreme speed probably. I have a really bad memory here, I'm sorry. So knowing whatever, I don't care, I have close combat, there we go. I had a Sash, I'm gonna go Stealth Rocks, I don't care. I need to put that up right now, so I can hit that Ninetales, and so I do. See, Focus Sash, yay! And also, this guy's extremely weak now because he got close combat, which is fine. He's probably gonna switch out. I hit up his Stealth Rocks, and I'm pretty much dead. So I'm like, Tyranitar, what you doing here, son? So I let him stay in there because I'm like, whatever. I just don't want to hit anything and get myself killed, so I let him die. He got rid of the Sun, so now his only option to bring the Sun back is Ninetales, which he's gonna hit by Stealth Rock, and it's poison too, so I'm like, oh. Now I get into Greninja, and I'm definitely faster, and I go for the stat Hydro Pump. And I have a little bit of a secret here. If I do recall myself, I was playing Splash Blade because we were playing item cost, and also I didn't have any choice items at the time, so I had like Life Orb leftovers, the plates, the element plates, I had Black Sludge and Air Balloon, that's all I have on my items, so I went, oh, Splash Blade, Hydro Pump set. Then he goes for Ninetales, Ninetales brings out Drought, cool. I'm still faster, I'm gonna do shit damage, so like I'm whatever, now I'm getting out. And I go for the Tentacruel. Why Tentacruel? Because this guy can't kill me. So he switched out. Yeah! And he goes for the Victory Bow. I do not know what offensive move he had, but it wasn't gonna be doing very much, and it's Victory Bow. It might be good on Sun, but either way, I'm poison too, so it's poison, it's not gonna do much. So I switch out once again, and I go for the Master of the Masters, Hunchcrow, the Pimp Crow, over here as I call him, with his little pimp hat. So he goes for the Solar Beam, and I am sure to survive this. Sure to survive the. Oh yeah, I will. I survived. Great. So I survived this, and now I go to Sucker Punch. Ooh, and we get the first plus one Moxie for Hunchcrow over here. So now this guy is Life Orb, Stab, Moxie, and I got quite a few hits left before I can go down. So now his only option here is to go into a non-attacking move to foil my Sucker Punch, which it does. Cause I'm pretty sure Ninetales has base 90 something. So excuse me, it's base 90 something, so it's faster than me, I guess. So I didn't want to risk that, so I went for punch anyways. But he's toxic, and next turn pretty much he's gonna die. So I withdraw, and I head into my friend Murmalo. Now he's gonna tank test the Solar Beam like a champ. And now on the next turn, well, at the end of his turn, my friend Ninetales will be gone. Yay! Tentacruel for the win. Honestly, this guy is like the best special sponge in the game, I think, in my opinion. He is so good. So good. So there goes Ninetales. There goes the Sun. I have defeated Danny. Well, thank you guys for watching.